everyone and welcome to our YouTube channel Learn at NoStar. Thank you all who participated in the quiz that we posted on our community tab relating to the order of execution of a SQL query. So these were the various options for the answers and we received different number of votes for the different options. The most votes came for the first option, which has the same order as the order in which the query is written, and then the second number of votes came for the option which is the correct option, which is the order of execution of a SQL query starts from, then goes to where, select, group by, order by, and so on. So if you want to understand that why this is the right option, then stay tuned. So here we have this query. Here we have a similar query that we are going to work with. We have this select statement over here where we are making a count on the product category. So let's first go to the tables and understand. So there are two tables that we're going to work with for this query. There's a table called the product category and product subcategory. Product categories has a list of like four categories, which are bikes, components, clothing, and accessories. And then product subcategory has the subcategories related to these categories, like mountain bikes, road bikes, and so on. So in our query, what we are trying to do now is we are trying to select all the product categories which have subcategories starting with the letter B, and the count of those subcategories within those product categories should be greater than one. So this is the query that we have written. We have a select statement in which we are selecting the count, and we are using a function to convert the product category name to upper case, and this is your SPC name from your two tables. So there are two tables, DIM product subcategory and DIM product category. We have performed a join on them on these keys, which is the product category key. Then we have a where statement wherein we are filtering on all the subcategories which start with the letter B. And okay, let's leave this portion out for a moment. And then we are grouping by the product category name, and then we're saying that the count star should be greater than one, and then we have a last statement for the order by. So now all this might seem confusing, but when we break it down, it will be very simple. So now if we try to understand the order of execution of the query in terms of how the database system will be executing this query, so the very first part that the database executes is the from part, the from over here, where you have mentioned the table names. This is to determine the working set of data on which then the different operations will be performed. So first to know that how many product categories have subcategories starting with the letter B, and the count within the category is greater than two, we have to know what are the categories and subcategories. So that is step one. So essentially, the very first step would be simply to go to the from part, look at the tables, perform any joins that need to be performed, and then determine the working set. So if we just execute this part, okay, this is the part that will be executed. Okay, so once you execute this part, you will be getting this result. This is your working set of data, which has all the data for your product subcategory and categories. So there is no filter being applied here, no specific columns being selected, nothing else being done, just your raw working set of data. Now the next step to limit this data set is to apply the where clause. So we have a condition that the subcategory name should start with B. So now the database system is going to apply the where clause. So the next step, first the order of execution from and joins, second step is executing the where clause. So if you execute just this much part of the query, now we have written a select start. This does not mean that the database is executing the select parts. It is not, but for displaying the output, when you write the query, we need to write the select part. That is why we have written it. But in the backend, the database is just calculating the from, the working set of the data from the from clause, and then applying filters on that data using the where clause. So essentially, after determining this working set, which we got over here, it's applying the where clause. Now, when it applies the where clause, the data gets limited. Now it is going to work with this set of data. So the next step it is going to do is now apply any aggregate functions, any groupings that need to be done. Because we have the filtered set of data, now we are in a position to apply the groupings. So the group by comes over here. Okay, so now it has performed a group by. So on the filtered data, now the group by has been performed. Once the group by has been performed, any having clause. Having clause only works on aggregated data, so which is essentially a filter on the aggregated data. Now the filter that we want to apply on this aggregated data is that the count star should be greater than 1. So essentially the clothing product category name should be dropped over here. So that is the next step that will be performed. And now you have your resultant data set. Now the select will be performed. So you have said that you want to select only the product category name. So now it will go and look at what columns need to be selected, what exact aggregate functions need to be applied, and it will apply those functions. Now we know that we have the filtered aggregated data output. Now we just need to format that data. So the last part is now executing the order by clause. Okay, order by is just sorting. So sorting has to be the final step because it has to be done on the resultant data set. So now a sorting will be applied using the order by clause. So that is the next step, that the last step that will be performed. This is how the various steps of the query will be executed in the backend. So we have to keep in mind that the writing order of the query, which starts from select, from where, group by, having, order by, is different from the order in which the query is executed at the backend. Now, another example for this case would be something like this. Let's say we have applied a function in our query, which is the upper function over here. So we are basically converting the product category name as in uppercase. And now, we have given an alias to this converted function as PC name. And now if we want to use, let's say, in a where clause, we want to add one filter and PC name equal to, let's say, bikes. And now if we execute this query, would this query work or would this query not work? Would it throw an error? So let's try to execute this query first. Okay, so it will throw an error. It is calling invalid column name PC name. Why it has thrown an error is because the database engine in the backend has not yet executed the select portion. So we have this condition added to the where clause. The select clause has not yet been executed. If the select clause has not yet been executed, that means it does not know what PC name over here is. That's why in the select clause, and if you want to use the same functions in the where clause, then you cannot use the alias. You have to put that function or apply that function all over again. So here, if you write an upper dim English product category name is equal to bikes, then this query is going to work. Okay, because there is nothing, no, we don't have any data of that kind, so the output is zero. But this query is going to work. So this is why it is important to understand the order of execution of a SQL query. I hope that this video was useful. If you found it useful, then please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks a lot for watching. Goodbye.